wish we'd brought a torch.
That seems nice and soft. Better let them out.
Now?
No, a week on Wednesday. Let them out, will you?
He still seems so at sea with everything. When I rang him this evening, he was looking for his gardening pullover. Ma must have put it away somewhere.
He'll sort himself out.
He needs me, Nick.
Well, you must do what you think is best.
More wine?
No, I've got an early start.
Are they digging in?
I can't see them.
Well, they must be doing the job then. You sure they've all gone under?
I knew we should have bought a torch.
Hello? Hello?
Shh, be quiet.
Don't leave me!
Shh, be quiet. Who's there? I can see you. There's three of you.
What's going on? Who is it?
It's a woman.
I thought I recognised that voice. You know who it is, don't you? It's Lord Ashfield's sister, Patricia. Come on, we better leave her.
Hey, but what are we going to do?
Come on, let's just go. Come.
What if she's dead?
She's not dead, she's just paralytic. Come on, somebody will find her.
Hey, well, what if they don't?
They will, come on.
Now, my Auntie Mabel did that just before she went.
Didn't she? You should have gone with her.
Please, come
on. Oh, get over.
She's coming round.
You'll be all right.
She fell over all by herself.
I think it's mainly alcohol.
That's what I said. Come on, let's leave it to the professional.
Do you have any idea who she is?
Not really. I think you'll find she got something to do with Ashfieldly Hall.
Ashfieldly Hall?
Yeah.
Well, no, thank you, sir. Goodbye, sir. Well, it looks like we're in Lord Ashfieldly's good books.
What makes a change?
He's most grateful to you, Ron, for driving his sister home last night.
Has her ladyship sobered up then, Sarge?
I believe her correct title is the Honourable Mrs. Patricia Brewster.
Pardon me?
I always think it's a good idea to observe the proper protocol when dealing with their sort of people.
You mean drunk, Sarge?
You know exactly what I mean, Rowan. Mrs. Brewster is married to an American millionaire. She's frequently in the papers.
Oh, she was always alive, alas. I remember her when old Lord Ashfieldly was alive.
Well, I didn't realise that you mixed with the gentry in your youth, Ventress.
She might be gentry, but she wasn't above leading the local lads on. She was a cracker.
You speaking from personal experience, then, Alf?
I wasn't always married to Mrs. Ventress, you know.
Well, she may have been a cracker in the old days, but she looked a right mess when Greengrass found her.
Greengrass? He found her?
Yeah, took her to Maggie Bolton's place.
What was he doing, skulking around in the middle of the night, eh?
Where do you go to, my lovely? When you're alone in your bed, tell me the thoughts that surround you. I want to look inside your head, yes, I do.
Yes. Good morning, Mrs. Brewster. I just thought I'd look in and see how you were feeling this morning. I'm Maggie Bolton, the district nurse from last night.
Oh, yes. Oh, I see. For a moment, I thought my wretched brother had hired some decent help. Ah, I should thank you for rescuing me.
Oh, Claude Greengrass did that.
Oh, I shall have to thank him.
Mrs. Brewster, I don't want to pry.
I'm sure you don't.
But you were very drunk last night. You blacked out.
Well, I'm sure we all have one too many from time to time. It was very good of you to call, but now you really must excuse me. Would you mind seeing yourself out?
by then.
Down at Old Green Grass, I'm paying you to get rid of them. Little blighters keep coming back. Well, look at the state of this lawn. This is the third time.
I'm doing my best, my lord. I mean, a lot of people think that foxes are cunning, but compared to your average mole...
Well, you can't put tennis nets up on this, can we?
No, your lordship.
Might be able to have a bit of a game of crazy golf.
Just get rid of them, will you?
Yes, my lord.
Come on, Meadows, I want to take a look at that spinny.
Ooh. Your father knew you caught him, Stephen.
We're doing nothing of the sort, Claude.
Oh, yeah. He must be raving mad, then. I wish he were 50 years younger. You could be my mother.
Gin and tonic, please. A large one.
Ice and lemon?
No lemon. I'm looking for a local chap. Does some odd jobs for my brother up at the hall.
Old Greengrass?
I gather this is his local.
Yeah, there he is. That'll be 4 and 10, please.
Mr. Greengrass?
Yes?
I'm Patricia Brewster. I think I owe you my thanks. And perhaps a drink.
Oh, very kind of you.
You live in a fancy apartment off the boulevard Saint-Michel, where you keep your Rolling Stones records and a friend of Sacha Distel. Yes, you do.
And Norman's a very sporty woman, your mother. And
hello, Steve.
I've never had
nice set of wheels outside.
Yeah, sitting over there with Greengrass.
Yeah, a very lucky man.
Well, that's what Sergeant Blakeson said last time he... Well, that last time we had a drink together.
Gina, have a word in private.
Whereabouts?
About this place.
I'll make myself scarce then.
No need.
Well, actually, it's about George. He isn't going to be running this pub any longer, so we need to consider the licence.
I know, but... Well, I'm just not sure what I want to do yet, Nick. I mean, working for me Uncle George was one thing, but... I don't know. I've never really seen myself as a pub landlady.
It's a good opportunity, Gina. Your own boss, your own business. But we do need to sort the licence out, and soon.
Say her again. Another large G&T in here. Large scotch and a shandy.
I think you're in danger of drinking him under the table. Maybe you should all slow down a bit.
I beg your pardon. This is my brother's public house. Are you refusing to serve me?
No, I was just...
And what are you? The barmaid? Who's in charge here?
I am.
Mrs. Brewster, PC Rowan, we met last night.
Oh, yes, of course. Let me buy you a drink too, Constable. Are you on duty?
Yes, I am on duty. Can you tell me, is that your car outside?
If you mean the Austin Healey, yes.
Do you intend driving it home?
Obviously.
Well, in that case, I think you've had a little bit too much to drink, don't you, Mrs. Brewster?
No. No, I don't. And I don't think you should take it upon yourself to interfere in my private affairs.
Or when it comes to drunken driving, the law obliges me to interfere.
I am not drunk. All I've had is a couple of gins. She'll tell you.
Well, clearly you've had a lot more than that. Now, if you do step into that car, I'm afraid I'll have to arrest you for driving under the influence of alcohol.
Really?
Listen, I've got an idea. Why don't you let Steve drive you home, Mrs. Brewster? You'd have had a few and you wouldn't want to go crashing that nice car of yours now, would you? And he's a good driver, aren't you, Steve?
Yeah, I'd be happy to help.
Save a lot of trouble all round, wouldn't it?
Well done, Gina. You're a born landlady.
it pretty badly, didn't I? It's the one thing I'm really good at.
Well, we all need a talent.
I just can't stand being told what to do.
Yeah, me neither. But that Nick Rowan, he's not a bad bloke, you know.
Yeah, policeman. I did only intend to have one, though.
Yeah, it's always fatal.
How did you end up behind the bar in the Aidensfield Arms?
I'm avoiding the sheep.
Are they after you, then?
Yeah, my dad farms sheep. Deepdale Farm. He wants me to take over from him. You know, following his footsteps. But sheep farming's not exactly my idea of the high life.
You're not Harry Adams' son, are you?
Yeah. Well, do you know him?
You're a lot like him.
Something must have come up, because he's usually back by now.
I'm really going to have to go. I thought I'd surprise Dad and drive over to York and cook supper.
How's he managing?
Oh, you know.
You look pretty exhausted to me, Jo. I hope you're not taking on too much.
Oh, I'm fine. I just had a busy day, that's all. I mean, I know I'm not being fair to Nick, but what can I do? Every time I ring up Dad, he's either lost something or...
He's lost his wife. And in the end, only he can come to terms with that.
But I must help him.
Jo, you are. Perhaps I ought to postpone my trip at half term.
Why? I can manage. Don't you want to see Antonin?
Of course I do. But if you're toing and froing to York and you've got Katie to look after...
I can manage, really. I'll just take Katie with me, that's all.
I wish I hadn't had all that whiskey yesterday.
Yeah, well, that means you should have stopped that ladyship from buying them for you, then.
Couldn't do that. It's against my principles. Yeah. Oh, how are you doing? There you go.
Nice, that big one.
Yeah, stick a few of these on. Yeah, come on. Yeah. Go on, stick them all in.
Oh. You may pull the wool over his lordship's eyes, but you don't fool me. I've got my sights on you.
Oh, yeah. You want to save that for your pheasants? Though, from what I hear, they're going to be a bit thin on the ground this year.
Says who?
I was talking to the keeper over at Sir Henry Bing's place. He reckon you'd be hard-pressed to find any birds at all to shoot on this estate.
Does he now? Well, his lordship is shooting at Sir Henry Bing's on Sunday. So we'll soon see how many birds they can put up.
Are you going with him, are you?
Of course I am. But I'll tell you something, Greengrass. Ashfordley Hall has still got the best pheasant shooting in this part of the country. And all Sir Henry Bing's money won't alter that.
Oh, what a charming room. Can I offer you some tea? Lovely. Right. You were very kind to me, Mrs. Bolton. And I wasn't exactly appreciative. But then, drunks never are. It's part of the disease. Are you saying you're an alcoholic? So I'm told. I have a very good man in Harley Street. I pay him a lot of money. He tells me what I don't want to hear. Would you rather he lied to you? Perhaps. Actually, I was hoping you might be able to do me a small favour. If I can. My doctor gives me Valium, which really does help me get through. But I've run out. I thought perhaps you may know the local chemist. Perhaps you could get me some.
You do need a prescription.
I'd be quite prepared to pay. It's not a question of money. You need a prescription.
Oh, sorry.
Jo, you remember Mrs. Brewster?
Of course.
Please, call me Patricia. I'll go and put the kettle on. I see you ride.
Yes, when I can.
That's what I must do. Get out in the fresh air. My brother's got a stable full of horses, but I hate riding alone. I don't suppose you'd care to join me.
Me?
Well, you'd be doing me the most enormous favour.
There you go. You take your stuff up and I'll pour you a pint.
Oh, thanks, bud. I don't drink. Room 3, did you say?
That's right. G&T, Steve. Just a small one.
Oh, I'm sorry. I...
Hey, Terry, it's Claude. Look, we're definitely in business. Yeah, they're all going. Day after tomorrow. Hey, give you a laugh. They're going shooting at Sir Henry Bing's place.
You have no right to chase me!
You nearly ran me off the road back there.
Nonsense!
Have you been drinking?
That is none of your business, Christopher.
If you wouldn't mind stepping out of the car, please, Mrs. Brewster.
What if I do mind?
Please, Mrs. Brewster.
I am warning you, you won't get away with this. I shall complain to the Chief Constable.
Well, she reckons it's all your fault. You've been harassing her.
She's lucky to be alive, Sarge. She was driving too fast. She's obviously been drinking. She couldn't even walk in a straight line. Shall I get the doctor to take a
Let's not be too hasty, Rowan.
Lord Ashford is here, Sarge.
Right. Ask him to come in.
Tea up.
You really don't understand how the world works, do you, Constable?
I understand that the law applies to you as much as anyone else, Mrs. Brewster.
Right, Rowan, that'll be all. Now then, Mrs. Brewster, I'm releasing you, but with a caution.
Sarge?
I said that'll be all, Rowan.
Come along, my dear.
She's a drunk, just because she's related to some local knob.
That's got nothing to do with it. I've made my decision. I don't want to hear any more about it.
She needs help.
And Lord Ashfordley assures me that she's getting it.
Nick, are you here? I've been waiting for you for the last half hour down the pub.
I'm sorry, darling. I forgot. Want a cup of tea?
Please.
I was thinking it's Saturday tomorrow. Do you want to go out for the day, just the two of us? Maybe drive up the coast?
I can't tomorrow. What about Sunday?
Well, I'm on duty. You don't have to see your dad every Saturday.
I'm not. I said I'd go riding with Mrs. Brewster.
Mrs. Brewster?
Yeah, look, Lord Ashley has some really good horses. It would be awkward to cancel it.
Why?
Well, it's a question of good manners, really.
Well, that's not something I'd associate with her.
Patricia's all right.
Oh, Patricia, is it?
Look, I like her. And it's not often that I get the chance to ride a really good horse.
And you'd rather do that than spend the day with me?
I've already agreed.
It looks like you've inherited some of your parents' snobbery after all.
What?
Look, I'm sorry, Joe. I had a bad day, that's all.
Oh, yes, and you, how you're feeling. That's always the most important thing, isn't it? You are selfish and arrogant, Nick. And I would rather go riding tomorrow than spend the day with you.
And what about marrying me? Perhaps you'd like to pass on that, too.
Yeah, perhaps I would.
should have thought of this before.
You never said you were such a good rider.
I used to know every inch of these hills. Used to ride in all weathers.
That can't have changed that much.
No. It's me that's changed. But let's not think about that today. Lovely day.
She'll come round.
Yeah, maybe.
You should never have made an issue of her going riding with that woman.
If that's the kind of people she wants to mix with, I can't compete with all that.
Well, Jo's kind. She always sees the best in people. And she hasn't seen the side of this Mrs. Brewster that you have, and you haven't explained any of that to her, have you?
I expect you're right.
I've got to go into York on Monday to do some shopping. I thought I might pop in and see how Mr. Weston's doing. What do you think?
Yeah, why not?
It's her worries about her father that are her real problem, you know.
Well, I'm not sure I can compete with him, either.
When I was young, my father stopped me from marrying. So when I was 21, I went out and married a vulgar American playboy. Just to spite him.
Are you still married?
He wants to divorce me, but it'll cost him too much. What about you?
I'm engaged to the local policeman, Nick Rowan.
Ah. Nice looking.
He's not exactly what my parents wanted for me either.
Well, parents aren't always wrong about these things. Do you know Harry Adams?
Slightly.
Hello, Harry. I met your son the other day. Maybe he mentioned it.
No. No, he never did.
Thought you'd buck up once you got some fresh air. Look, I'm going over to Bing's tomorrow for a couple of days. You're going to be all right?
Of course.
You know what I'm saying, Patty. Stay off the sauce.
I thought I might ask Harry Adams and his wife to dinner when you get back.
Harry Adams? Whatever for? Don't be ridiculous.
I need company, Charlie. Friends.
Well, not Adams, though. Anyway, he wouldn't come.
I bumped into him today. He was very friendly.
He's got a damn cheek.
Oh, for goodness sake. That was all 20 years ago.
Patty, I have to live here. These people are my tenants.
I'll tell you one thing living in America's done for me. Cured me of English class snobbery.
It's not a question of snobbery. It's social etiquette. He'd feel uncomfortable, poor fellow.
You'd feel uncomfortable.
Well, you're not inviting him, and that's that. Look, I've got things to do. I'll see you at dinner.
Hope you don't mind me trespassing again.
Sorry I was so tongue-tied this morning. Thought I'd seen a ghost.
Surely I didn't look that bad.
Never thought you'd come back to Yorkshire.
Neither did I.
Hi, Terry.
Hello, Claude. This shoot at Henry Whatnot's. It's definitely on then.
Apparently they're going tomorrow. They'll be away a couple of days.
And I'll need to see the lie of the land, though.
I'll need to do that first thing. Where's he? Alfred, come back here. Come here.
Hey, what's all...
I don't know. Probably an Iker or a Twitcher or something. They're a flaming nuisance.
Well, there's a good deal of money at stake here. Rival syndicates with an eye on our patch. Security's a matter of some concern.
Well, you don't think he's...
Well, you never know. Best keep an eye open.
Steve is the eldest. I've got two others, Anna and Philip. You?
Kids. No. We were always travelling. The social world, you know. Max inherited a fortune, and he's determined to spend it or perish in the attempt.
I used to read about you sometimes. My wife's magazines. Having such a grand time.
God, how I hated my father.
all his blue-blooded pride and pomposity.
Oh, he just wanted you to be happy, Patricia. And you were right. We were far too young to marry.
He just wanted me to do what I was told.
I was, speaking about you to my brother. We're having a few people over for drinks tomorrow evening. He wondered if you'd care to join us.
Well, well, that's very kind, but...
Oh, Harry, times have changed, surely.
Where you've been, maybe, but not so much around here.
It was just a thought.
You know, Patricia, if you were ever in any trouble or you needed out,
I'm well, Claude.
I've been doing a bit of moulding for his lordship. I've been here practically every day this week, getting an eyeful and earwig.
Well, it's time we made some real brass, eh?
Alfred, where's he? Hey, David, go and put a bit of string on him or something, will you? What's the matter with him?
This is going to be a neat little job, Claude. But I've got to get to a telephone. Line up some troops.
Right. David, where's he gone? David! I'll put a bit of string on you. David!
Nice dog.
Alfred! David!
Is that your dad?
Mr. Greengrass?
No. Can I...
I'll see you in a couple of days. Any problems? Give me a call at Bing's. Come on, old thing, you'll be all right.
Don't fuss, Charlie, I'm not a child.
Right on time. Good.
What did I tell you? Hey, there's a bit of luck. The ladyship's going with him.
A back way in for our vehicles.
No problem, come.
I can't believe that this place hasn't been hit before.
I know, we're a bit out of the way up here.
Dawn tomorrow, Claude. We'll put Ashfordley Hall on the map.
You talk like Marlene Dietrich, and you dance like Zizi Jamet. Your clothes are all made by Balmain. And there's diamonds and pearls in your hair, yes there are. You live in a fancy apartment off the boulevard Saint-Michel. We keep beer rolling.
Max sent you, didn't he? You're working for Max.
Sorry?
I won't be intimidated, you know. He's put private detectives on me before, but I can make life very uncomfortable for you. Very uncomfortable indeed.
Are you saying your husband is in the habit of having you followed?
Yes. And I've seen this fellow before when I was out riding. And then today he was watching the house. Why, I saw the binoculars round his neck. When I confronted him, he was pretending to repair his bicycle. I think I've seen him in the Aidensfield Arms, too.
Could be just a coincidence.
Oh, so now I'm paranoid too, am I?
No one is suggesting that, Mrs. Brewster.
My husband is a very rich man, Sergeant. He wants a divorce, but he doesn't want to pay for it. So he's hoping to portray me as the guilty party. I may be a lot of things, but I'm not that.
I'm sure you're not, Mrs. Brewster. And if this man is harassing you, on his own or on your husband's account, we'll certainly look into it and put a stop to it.
Thank you, Sergeant.
I shall mention how helpful you've been to the Chief Constable next time I see him.
Well, that's very kind of you, Mrs. Brewster.
Right, Rowan, you better find this joker and fast.
Sarge?
I want no stone left unturned. Do you understand me?
Yes, Sarge.
Harry? It's me, Patricia. You said if I was in trouble, if I needed anything.
He's never a private detective, Nick. He's too nervy.
Well, who can tell, Gina? Perhaps he's heavily in disguise. Ah, Mr. Potter.
What do you want? I haven't done anything.
Come in. I'm afraid we started without you.
You're right.
I am now. Charlie's gone shooting, so I thought I'd take the opportunity of inviting a few old friends.
I don't understand. When you phoned me this morning, you said someone was following you.
Oh, they are. Now, what you need is a glass of champagne.
What's going on, Patricia? There's no one else here.
Seems I don't have too many old friends. Never mind. What shall we drink to?
So, Mr. Potter, you're not a private detective and you weren't following Mrs. Brewster.
I only had a puncture. She stopped the car and started to threaten me. I didn't know who she was.
But you have been following someone. That's why you're in the Ashbury Hall, isn't it?
They're planning a burglary of some sort. I overheard them.
What? At Ashfordly Hall?
They said they couldn't believe it had never been it before. But dawn tomorrow, they were going to put it on the map.
Do you remember when I got married? As I walked out of the church on Max's arm, I saw your face in the crowd. Oh, you looked so desolate.
It were a long time ago.
I've never stopped loving you.
My son Steve's been telling me that you got yourself into quite a mess. Drink and the like. You need some proper help.
I need you. If we could only...
Don't be ridiculous. No one can turn the clock back. And I wouldn't want to.
Stay with me. Stay here just for tonight.
Patricia, don't do this. It spoils everything.
Once I get a divorce, I will be a millionaire, and then we can make up for all the time we've lost.
Look, I got a wife and a family that I love.
Harry, I'm begging you, don't go. You're my last chance. I swear I'll kill myself!
You can't do this to me, Patricia.
Hello, Nick.
Hello, Maggie. Peace offering.
I'll leave you to it.
I'm sorry, Jan. I've got no right to pick on your friends, whoever they may be.
Yeah, I'm sorry too. But I'm not a snob, Nick.
No, I know.
Hello. Patricia, I wondered if you'd fancy coming over. To tell you the truth, Joe, I could do with some company.
I'm sorry, Patricia, I can't. I'm busy this evening. Yes, I've got someone with me.
Don't try to understand me. You never could do that. Oh, in the end, you'd wind up being hurt. I'm a man with too many problems that keep pounding on my brain. So if you want me, you take me for what I'm worth. If you want me, you take me for what I'm worth.
a saint. My sins, they are many. But there's no one perfect in this universe. And though you think I'm weird, don't try and change me, dear. 'Cause if you want me, you'll take me for what I'm worth. Inside my door, there's restlessness within. Oh, I'm like a rain cloud that one day may burst. We both know I'll be leaving, and if one little tear you breathe, oh, it's alright.
Practically kicked the door down.
There's no reply,
so I called you.
No staff.
No, she's giving everyone the night off. His lordship's away.
Mrs. Brewster?
Patricia?
Joe? Better call an ambulance. What do you think?
Oh, it's hard to say. There could have been 30 to 40 tablets in those bottles. If she took them all, well, she was certainly serious about wanting to do away with herself. I'm going to the hospital with Harry.
I remember the night old Lord Ashville had come to see my father. In those days, the most important thing was know your place. And, he told my father straight. It weren't fitting for his daughter to marry son of a tenant farmer. My father agreed with him.
Did you love her very much?
I... Well, I was only 19. She was shipped off to Switzerland, some finishing school. I got on with my life. Next I heard she was to marry some rich American.
She'd have been better off with you.
No. Don't think so, really. She were a lovely girl, but she was spoiled. She weren't brought up to work for a living. She just thought the rest of the world were there for her amusement.
Looks like she's going to pull through.
Harry, thank you for raising the alarm. Awful business.
It may not be for me to say, Your Lordship, but she needs some proper professional help. You know, psychiatrist or whatever.
Yes, indeed. It's all in hand. I'm very grateful.
Come on, David. We'll be there about midnight if you don't hurry up.
He likes me, your dog.
Yeah, well, we'll eat oat. Hey, come on, son. Come on. What are you doing hanging about here, anyhow?
Thought we could have a bit of a chat.
Did you? Well, you're out of luck, because I've got an appointment. And in any case, this is private property, so up it.
What time do you call this?
Don't start. We had to wait about half an hour for this lot.
Aye.
All right, David, leave it to me.
I was beginning to think that you'd got lost.
Been a lot easier, Bell, if you'd just told us where the shoe was to be.
Oh, didn't I mention it? It's the Ashfordley estate.
Best shooting in the county, sir.
Splendid. Will Lord Ashfordley be joining us?
Not from what you were saying last night, no.
Well, anything?
No, Sarge. I'll check round the back too.
Well, maybe all the activity last night put them off.
Maybe. We'll give them a bit longer.
What do you reckon, Sarge?
Well, it's your information, Rowan. What do you reckon?
They led up the garden path.
Looks like Lord Asperdy, Sarge.
Blayton?
What's going on? Well, the information seemed reliable, sir. Ashley Hall was clearly the target.
You've been very thorough, Blaketon. I'm grateful.
Over there! Come on, Blaketon!
I always said Greengrass is a poacher, not a burglar.
They're over here, your lordship.
That cheek. Lay down your gun! What's the meaning of this? I'll have you know, sir, we've paid good money for a day's shooting.
Not to me, sir, you haven't.
Nice of you not to run us over, Claude.
I'm glad I went over to Aidensfield.
A change of scene is often the best medicine.
Indeed.
When I lost my husband, I remember thinking, what on earth do I do with myself now? I felt abandoned.
I know what you mean. Joe's been very helpful to me, though. Coming over, keeping me company.
She's got a very good heart, your daughter.
I know. I hope you don't think I'm taking advantage of it.
I'm sure no one would blame you if you were.
I want Joe to be happy, you know. She's got a whole life ahead of her. I don't want her worrying about me.
Hard for any daughter not to in the circumstances.
My wife was never sure about Nick. But he seems a pretty solid chap to me. I think they'll make a go of it, don't you?
Yes, I think so.
I am telling you the truth. He said he were a land surveyor and he'd give me a few quid if I'd show him about a bit.
You don't seriously expect me to believe that, do you, Greengrass?
You know. Anybody else, yes.
We're going to find your partner in crime, Greengrass. And when we do, you're going to be for the high jump.
How are you feeling? Flowers. How quaint. You don't smoke, do you? I'd sell my soul for a cigarette.
No, sorry. Last night, when you phoned, I'm sorry. I
don't want your pity. Or your guilt. I never expected Harry to come back, you know.
He was worried about you.
Oh, I can't think why. I mean nothing to him anymore. Take a tip from me, Joe. You're only young once. Be selfish and enjoy it. And don't let anyone tell you what to do.
Yes,
Sarge, there's no one at Greengrass's place apart from Mr. Potter here.
And we checked the rendezvous point, there's nothing.
And all our sporting gentlemen seem to know about Greengrass's accomplice is that he comes from Leeds.
Are you going to release him then, Sarge?
I think I'll have to.
But I thought I could...
Yes, Mr. Potter would like to have a word with Greengrass, Sarge. There's a young man here who's come to pray for your soul.
Pray for me what? What exactly are you up to? I've got a feeling it's down to you I'm in here.
I just wanted you to repent. I just wanted you to... Do you remember Betty Sampson? She was a barmaid in Whitby 20 years ago.
Well, what about it?
She was my mother. She put me up for adoption. I'm training for the priesthood.
Are you? What's it going to do with me?
Well, before I commit myself to my heavenly father, I wanted to find out who my real earthly father was.
Hey, hang on. You're not suggesting...
I'm called Graham now, but when I was born, she called me Claude.
Did she? This is your idea of a joke, Blaketon. You can't nick me fair and square. She had to flaming set him on me.
We're not joking, Greengrass. I think the discovery of your long-lost son is something you should take very seriously indeed.
Not my son, Betty Sampson. I mean, you must remember Betty Sampson, Alf. Let's face it, he could be anybody's.
Anybody's? I don't think the lad necessarily needs to hear that, Claude.
It wasn't me that started it, was it? Hang on a minute. Am I being nicked or not?
Well, you're free to go for the time being.
Thank you very much. I'm sorry, lad. The point is, your mother was a very nice woman. It's just that she had a bit of a friendly disposition.
Take it easy, Sansan.
If he is, he has all my sympathy.
You've made a good life yourself, Joe. I'm really pleased about that. Your mother would be, too.
I've been thinking, Dad. Now that you're on
your own... Yes, well, I've been thinking, too. In fact, I've been making a few plans. I spent a lot of time in the Far East during the war, and I've always wanted to go back, but your mother never fancied it. But now... Well, I've got some money put by, and I thought, now's the time to do it before I get too old. What do you think?
Well, wouldn't you mind, I mean, travelling all on your own?
No, I don't think I would. I could suit myself, go at my own pace. In fact, I'm rather looking forward to it. I wouldn't go before the wedding, of course.
I think it's a wonderful idea, Dad. I really do. Listen to me, I'll sing a song to
change your mind. Here is a deputy. Hey, my two favourite girls in the whole world.
I popped over to see Dad this afternoon. We were saying it's about time we fixed a date for the wedding.
For our wedding? Are you still planning on marrying me, then?
Well, I'm planning to marry you. Who are you planning to marry?